Good evening, I'm Barbara Brozier. A room in the basement of Purdue University's Electrical Engineering building where teaching a student was killed in 2014 will soon be used again. Purdue this summer will start renovations on a large portion of the basement, including the room where 21-year-old Andrew Bolt was fatally shot and stabbed by a fellow student. The space where the room is located will become part of a senior design project laboratory scheduled to open in fall 2017. Purdue plans to create a memorial for Bolt in the building. A committee that will study how Indiana should go about replacing the troubled I-STEP exam held its first meeting at the State House today. The 23-member study panel heard testimony from experts during a three-hour hearing, but is a long ways away from making formal recommendations to lawmakers. The committee faces a tight deadline to come up with a replacement for the exam. The I-STEP will be repealed in July 2017 under a bill Governor Mike Pence signed into law in March. A Southern Indiana hospital will open a new emergency department tomorrow after flash flooding caused severe damage several years ago.
Healthcare is changing rapidly, and so we obviously are constantly upgrading, constantly innovating with the state-of-the-art technology.
Columbus Regional Hospital suffered nearly $180 million in damage in 2008. The new emergency room is twice the size and is designed to handle twice as many patients. The hospital invested $16 million in the ER. Now let's take a look at your weather. Tonight, a 40% chance of thunderstorms with a low of 63 degrees. And folks, keep that umbrella handy the rest of the week because that rain could be sticking around. Tomorrow, a 50% chance of thunderstorms, a high of 82. Thursday, a 40% chance of storms and a high of 82. Have a great night.